Anita Morgan says, what nutrients are needed to break down old damaged bone and build new bone? So you are breaking down bone all the time throughout every second of your life. We are always breaking down bone. We are always building up new bone. And if you had any kind of defect in the ability to break down old bone, then you would have problems manifesting elsewhere, because bone breakdown is necessary to maintain your serum calcium levels. You would probably be having severe hypocalcemic attacks if you were not breaking down your bone, your old bone. And you would probably also have exercise intolerance and or poor exercise performance as a result of the undercarboxylated osteocalcin released from bone, which it acts as a hormone to improve energy utilization during exercise. And if you don't have those problems, you probably have the capacity to break down bone. And in fact, unless you're taking a bone resorption inhibitor, in which case the way to break down old bone would be to get off the bone resorption inhibitor. In fact, the overwhelming problem in the general population is that people are breaking down too much bone and not building it back up enough. So if you just look at the course of someone's life over time, when we are young, we are building more bone than we're breaking down. And that somewhere around 25 years old or so, give or take a few years, and it depends on male and female, we reach peak bone mass, and then we spend the entire rest of our lives declining in bone mass. Why are we declining? Because we're breaking down bone faster than we're building up. So almost everyone has the capacity to break down bone and just is really missing out on the building new bone elements. To some degree, when you're building new tissue, you need everything. And so eating a nutrient-dense diet across the board is important. But for things that are extremely important that kind of stand out from building other tissues when you're building bone is collagen. So about half your bone is protein, about 95% of the protein in your bone is collagen. The limiting factor for collagen synthesis is glycine. Collagen peptides provide glycine, and they also are better at stimulating collagen synthesis than just powdered glycine. So collagen peptides, bone broth, edible bones from canned fish or from the ends of small chicken bones would all probably be helpful. And then clearly calcium and phosphorus are the overwhelming minerals in bones. So you need enough calcium and you need enough phosphorus. Between the two of those in the population, most people do not get enough calcium and get too much phosphorus. People get phosphorus from processed foods and from soda, in addition to the natural phosphorus in meat and other foods. If you are not eating junk food, you probably don't get too much phosphorus, but you still probably get enough. If you're not eating junk food and you're not eating dairy and you're not eating bones, you probably do not get enough calcium. And in particular, many people in the natural health community have read a lot of anti-calcium supplementation stuff. I want to emphasize over and over again that it's better to get calcium from food than to get calcium from supplements, but it's better to get calcium from supplements than to not get calcium. And so if you're not eating bones and you're not eating green vegetables to some extent, but mainly bones and dairy products, then you need to supplement with calcium or find some other way to get 1,000 to 1,500 milligrams of calcium in. And then beyond that, there's a lot of trace minerals in bone. Magnesium is certainly important for bone building. There's not a lot of magnesium in bone, but magnesium and copper and vitamin C to support the proper production of collagen, manganese. I mean, you start getting to every nutrient directly or indirectly plays some importance in the bone. And so if you've addressed the things that I just said, then you really want to look very personally and individually at what is your weakest link, because after those main factors, it could be almost anything.